will not express support for Taslima Nasreen. The liberals who defend Pakistani artists in India will never defend free speech of Salman Rushdie. Indian leaders who host Ghulam Ali, the Pakistani singer, will not host K.R. Rahman. Indian secularism loves Pakistanis, not Indian Muslims. To conclude, these ideological narratives cause negative deficit in our nation's conversation. It causes anguish among Indian groups. The German military writer, Clausewitz wrote, "War is the continuation of politics by other men." The reason Indians today do not want Pakistani artists is because Pakistan is in a state of war against us by other men. Pakistan has not formally declared a war. Indian people understand the obvious fact of our times that we are in a state of war based by Pakistan by all means, by other means as well. So what is the JNU student, what is the message to you which I want to give? I think each JNU student must exercise free speech. In all societies, people are free speech but they do not exercise. So your free speech begins the moment someone challenges your free speech. Free speech belongs to only those people whose free speech is challenged. Free speech must be defended from the moment someone begins to challenge. On the JNU campus, free speech of communists is not challenged. It is the free speech of non-communists that is challenged. On the JNU campus, therefore, free speech belongs to anti-communists, not the communists who hegemonize and dominate the debate here. Free speech is unlimited because it is unlimited for communists on the JNU campus. Free speech becomes necessary for the reason it is challenged. If a book is banned or a cartoon is not allowed, you and I must defend that book and draw the cartoon. I will defend the free speech of Sitaram, actually if everybody opposes it. In JNU, but free speech essentially belongs to Subramanian Swami, because on this campus it is his free speech that is disallowed. Free speech essentially belongs to someone or some group whose free speech is challenged. On JNU campus, you know whose free speech is challenged. The counter-nationalism in India can be defeated. This is my message. Only through free speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Namaji, for your every presentation. It's quite analytical. I'm sorry. Good morning, Dr. Namaji, and the campus. I have some differences with you. It's not that. Hegemonizing attitude of our police, apart from the communist practice, they have to give them a secret also. So in the last decade, that is why the nuclear one, remember, was a rise with that. So we have these kind of rise of mixture, with this they did, legal secret, as it happened in Madigan, and ex-communist. And so together they have been dominating a discourse, dominating both institutions and the discourse. Anyway, thank you very much for running so much time. So I now, I call up the organizer, and in case somebody to propose for our hands. Or you want the close to the group for some comments and questions? Here we go. 10 minutes. Yeah, 10 minutes. So let's go to this open forum. Very brief. Just identify yourself and try to be very brief and precise.